Hi everyone, my name is Leah Kopke and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. In each one of these episodes, we go over another 3D modeling tool for Cinema 4D. And today's 3D modeling tool is called Stitch and Sew. So let's jump into Cinema 4D and show how it works. So here we are inside of Cinema 4D. And I have this scene set up here. We have this tray, and it's actually within a subdivision surface, but I have that subdivision surface off for right now. I thought this would be a good example on how to use Stitch and Sew. So what I'll do is I'll zoom in here, and you can see that these handles are actually open in the center. So we're going to fix that with our Stitch and Sew tool. And we can find our Stitch and Sew tool with the hotkey MP. But first, before we stitch and sew these edges together, what we'll need to do is select them. And you may remember loop selection from a previous episode. If you haven't seen it yet, I'll leave a link to it in the description below. But I'll use the hotkey UL in order to select these loops, and I'll select them in edge mode. So I'll select this loop, hold down shift, select the second loop. And now with these edges selected, we can stitch and sew them together using the hotkey MP. So if I just hit M, you can see our hotkeys come up, and under P is stitch and sew. So we'll select that there. And this tool works different ways depending on what hotkeys you use while you're using it. So initially, if we hold down shift while dragging from one edge to the other, actually before I do that, I want to turn off create Endguns. If you don't already have that turned off, make sure that's off because I just like to show this tool without that on initially. So I'll hold down shift and I'll drag from one edge to the other, and it created another surface in here connecting those two edges, so we have a very nice handle. So that's the first way to use it. That's what shift does. And I'll undo that for right now. If we just drag from one edge to the other, you'll see that it welded the first edge to the second edge. You can see that on the second side, the first edge is welded to the second edge. I'll hit undo. So if we do that in the opposite direction, you can again see the first edge is welded to the second edge. And there's another option on how you can use this tool. If you hold down control while dragging one edge to the other, it will weld them in the center. So instead of welding the first edge to the second edge in the location of the second edge, we've just welded those together in the middle. So those are the three options on how to control this while in edge mode. I'll hit undo. And again, we briefly talked about create Endguns. So if you turn on create Endguns, it will actually be using a different algorithm for the Stitch and Sew tool that is similar to the bridge tool. And while you are using Stitch and Sew, it will create a big Endgun basically while you're doing it. So I'll just show you what that looks like. I'll again hold down shift while dragging one edge to the other. And you can see here that now we just have one big Endgun. And an Endgun is a polygon with more than four edges. A quad, like this one here, has four edges. A triangle has three edges. So if I click on this here, you can see that's one polygon all the way wrapping around, and that's called an Endgun. So I'll delete that for now just to show you. If we have visible only on the Stitch and Sew tool, so I'll click MP, only select visible elements. That will mean that you'll only be using this tool with what is visible to your camera. and I'll turn off create end guns for right now. I'd just like to show you a little bit more of what you can do with this tool. So I'm going to hit this plus button here to create a new project, and I'll come over to my primitives and I'll add in a plane. I'll make our plane 150 inches by 150 inches because I like round numbers. And then you can turn on garage shading lines in order to see our segments. 10 is fine for width and height, so I'll keep that as is. You can either hit the C hotkey to make this primitive editable, or you can hit this icon here. They both do the same thing. And now with that done, I want to show you a little bit of how this would work in point mode. So if I grab our points option here, I can drag from one point to the other after using the hotkey MP. So I'll click MP and I'll drag from one point to the other, and it welded that first point to the second point. If I click on one point and drag it to the other while holding control, it'll weld them in the center. So very similar to the edge tool, it'll weld the first point to the, or the first selection to the second selection. If you are just clicking and dragging, if you hold down control, it'll weld in the middle of those two selections. Similar to edge mode, it does it also in point mode. And you can even do that with individual edges. So if I clicked and dragged this edge to this edge, it welds the first selection to the second. If I hold down control and drag this edge to this edge, it welds them in the middle. So that's how that works. You can also use this tool with polygons. So if I go ahead and use my selection, brush selection, and I have polygon mode selected, I can select a few polygons here. I can use MP to go back into the tool, and I can drag from one side of the polygons to the other, and it welds that side to the second side. So that's how that looks. And if we do that again, but we hold down control, I'm sure you can guess what'll happen. It welds them together in the center. So that's basically how it's working in terms of that. And I really hope this helps you understand how to use this tool. It's a really helpful one on projects. Instead of using a cube, let's drop in a sphere. And let's grab these polygons after making this editable with the C hotkey. I'll use UL and I'll select here. I'll select here, we'll delete that, and we'll use MP in point mode, and we'll hold down shift, and we can weld from one side to, actually, I need to select this loop first, and then we can hold down shift after using MP, stitch and sew. And now we've closed up that top of this sphere using stitch and sew. So it's really useful. You can even have two entirely separate objects. Like, let's say we have the cylinder here and we make it editable. We go into polygon mode and we delete that area here. If you're working on something and there's two separate parts that you want to bring together, you can use UL, select these two edge loops, and use MP, and hold down shift and drag, and we'll connect them together. So this works on a lot of different things, and you can create all different kinds of shapes, 3D modeling with this. It's really helpful. I find it useful for making windows when 3D modeling buildings, and I'm sure you'll find plenty of helpful ways to use it as well. And if you have any questions, let me know in the comments. If you'd like to learn more 3D modeling tools for Cinema 4D, please hit like and subscribe. I look forward to seeing you next time on Ambient 3D Animations. Thank you so much for watching.